everyone. Keep it down. Cole Phelps joins the arson squad today. How'd you like porking that German whore, Phelps? Phelps is up before a review board in December. Until then, he works the arson desk. End of story. Phelps.
Yes, sir.
I don't care what you did or didn't do, Phelps. I hear you're a good case man. But if you fuck up on my detail, I'll have you out of here before your feet touch the ground. Do we have an understanding?
Yes, sir.
Cap, we don't want a fucking rat like Phelps.
Can it, Tilden? Phelps, I'm partnering you with Herschel Biggs.
I don't do partners. You know that, Cap.
You do now, Biggs. Social basket cases like you two should get along just fine. Biggs will show you the ropes, Phelps.
This is arson. There are no ropes.
It shouldn't take long, then. Start with these two. House fires. 326 South Kenmore Avenue. Stefan's family was out of town when it happened. Then go to 4414 Rosewood, family by the name of Sawyer. Fire brigade will be on location.
Are they suspicious, Captain?
That's for you to find out, Detective. Now get out of here. Both of you. Get out!
Here. What's he waiting for? Oh, Susie, you are so bad. The nerve from
here. Parker or Green? I don't know who this is. Guy gave his wife a tap. Say all fair in love and war.
You can drive.
How long have you been working arson?
We gonna do the small talk thing now? Talk baseball, exchange addresses? I don't think so. Feeling down, hotshot? Need a buddy? Or look somewhere else.
There isn't much left.
There never is if the job's done properly.
You think it was deliberate?
Nah, that's real pain in her face. They would have moved out the things they care about if this was insurance. There's no mileage in this. Hello, Mike.
Hey, Hirsch. Cap this one.
Yeah, Mike Brannigan, Cole Phelps. It's okay, Brannigan. His name may be dog shit, but there's none on his hand.
No offense, Phelps.
None taken. Do you have anything?
The fire started late last night. Stefan's family at Catalina Island won some kind of competition. Looks like the only thing they ever won in their lives. You come home with us.
I'd say they were pretty lucky, really.
They don't have any insurance. Everything they own, including the house, is now that pile of rubble.
Where are they sleeping?
In the car. It's lucky the whole block didn't burn down. Word is they're bulldozing this whole neighborhood to build new homes for GIs. That's the man in the house. In the ruins. Terry Lady is his wife.
We'll take a look around. Come on, Phelps.
He's the dirty cop from the newspaper.
Mr. Stephens? Cole Phelps and Herschel Biggs, LAPD. I know it's a difficult time, but could we have a word?
Don Stephens.
You were out of town.
We won a prize. We had a wonderful time. Came home to this.
Do you still have the tickets?
Sure.
It's a formality, but we'll need to speak to the issuing agent. you tell me any more about the prize that you won, Mr. Steffens?
Weekend at Catalina Island. My wife got this flyer in the mail from the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
Did you enter any kind of competition?
My wife filled in a flyer. This lady just rung up and told us we won. It's the first time I ever won anything.
The Redevelopment Fund. Did they offer to buy you out?
They're building new houses. They showed their money and most of the neighborhood just packed up and walked away. But I never bargained with them.
Everyone else is selling, but you're the holdout, aren't you?
Yeah, I was the last. I thought I could hold out for a better price. Now, my house is the center lot.
So now you have to take the price regardless.
Looks like it. I've got no choice. I have to put a roof over my family.
That's all we need for the moment, Mr. Steffens.
All right.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need information on the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
Yes, Detective. Just checking. The fund is a semi-government agency established to speed up the building of GI homes. It has private investors as well as a government endowment.
Huh. Do you have an address for them?
There is one listed here, corner of Beverly and Mariposa.
Thank you. Recently serviced. Could be something to go on. Been any other house fires?
This is arson. We get an average of two a night. Does that answer your question?
Thank you.
Hi, Albert. We've caught this case.
Hey, Biggs. We? You have a partner? What gives?
This is Cole Phelps. You may have read about
him. Oh, now I get it. Hello, Phelps. Welcome to the netherworld of arson. Family of four found dead in their beds. Heater explosion.
Yeah, another one?
Looks that way. Instaheat Model 70. Before you get excited, we get a couple of water heaters a month go back. Take a look around the yard and see what you can find.
Val.
You gonna stick it out, Cole?
I'm gonna try, Mal. What have you got?
Family by the name of Sawyer. Mother, father, and two kids. All in bed from the looks of it. Well, I'd say carbon monoxide poisoning. The burns are superficial.
Time of death?
I'd say about midnight. Anything more exact will take some time to determine. Lynch tells me this has something to do with a faulty water heater.
Could be. There's been a spate of problems with a particular brand. I've got another angle in mind.
You care to elucidate, Detective? This is a murder and not an accident. Sharing information has helped us solve quite a few cases together.
I need something concrete now before the department gets wind of it. I'm in arson for a reason.
I feel sorry for your wife and kids, Phelps, not for you. But you're a good case man, one of the best I've ever met. I'll help in any way I can.
Thanks, ma'am. I'd say that's firm but fair. How about the insurance companies write these incidents up as acts of God?
Hey, Biggs, is this significant?
Regulator valve. Good find.
Detective, this is the next door neighbor.
Detective Phelps, can you help?
They were supposed to be going away. They won a trip somewhere. But little Henry got sick, so they had to cancel. What are the chances?
Do you know who ran the competition?
Gulliver's Travel, up on Santa Monica Boulevard.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
Phelps, the guy across the street. I've seen him before. He likes fire.
Hurry, you can still catch him.
Stop! LAPD!
What's the rush?
We got an ID on you, Firebug. Stop right there.
What's your name?
Herbert Chapman.
So you like fires?
Some.
Watching them or setting them?
I don't want any trouble.
Turn out your pockets.
You're a naughty boy, aren't you, Herbert?
I keep myself to myself.
Cigarette in a matchbox gives you a 5 or 6 minute delay. You want more time, you use a mosquito coil. Don't you, Herbert?
You light this fire, Herbert?
Hell no. I heard it over the fire radio. Sounded sweet.
When you finish following your leads, come and see me at the fire station. I have a theory about this.
Will do, Lynch. Take this guy in. We might want him for questioning later.
You got it, Detective.
Why have you got such a hard-on for this case? If it is murder, it's almost impossible to prove. Fire doesn't leave much evidence. There's no percentage in this.
I think it's more than one case.
They're house fires, Cole. Accidents, heater fires, gas explosions.
There's got to be a reason.
The reason is you want to be a star. Forget it. Give it up. You'll feel better.
There's something to this. I know it.
What are you talking about? Arson is insurance. It's always been insurance.
We still investigate the cases, Biggs. The people in this house are dead.
Go soak your head, Phelps. This hero business is a full-time obsession with you.
I'm gonna make this case. I'm gonna rub the department's nose in it. Help me,
or stay out of my way. You got it?
I'd rather get there in one piece.
Any available unit, meet the officer. 211 just occurred. At 253 Main Street, unit to handle code 2 identified.
Detectives Phelps and Biggs, LAPD.
John Cunningham, can I help you, gentlemen?
We have reason to believe that the Sawyer family of 4414 Rosewood Avenue recently won a competition run by your company.
Yes, I remember them. They called up to cancel at the last minute. One of the kids was sick. Very unfortunate.
Do you mind if I take a look at that?
Here they are, Stephens.
Tell us about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
There's not much to tell. They run a promotion. Our promotions mailing list covers half of LA.
So they are not a government agency?
I don't believe so. Government organizations don't usually get involved in promotions.
I'm told the tickets were a prize.
Yes, they were.
You do a lot of these prizes?
Look, there are hundreds of these promotions running at any one time. If you're the lucky guy, you get your name pulled out of a hat.
While the Sawyer family were supposed to be at Catalina Island, their house burnt down. You consider them lucky?
Christ. I'm sorry to hear that.
Can you tell me who offered the prize won by the Sawyer family?
Sure. Look, there's supposed to be some sort of supervised draw with hundreds of tickets. But the reality is the Suburban Redevelopment Fund calls me every couple of weeks and tells me exactly who's won.
Thanks for your help.
No problem. Wish I could do something for that family.
You could put round the hat. A few bucks would really help them now.
I suppose so.
Good. I'll put you down for 50. I could tell you were Samaritan the minute I walked in the
50?
Door.
50? Are you...
Good man, Cunningham. You're all right.
Yeah, I'm great. Poorer, but great.
Can you drive to this one?
And where exactly are we going?
Mm-hmm.
Let me guess. You want to check out the Suburban address?
Great partners must think alike, Murphy.
This is supposed to be the registered offices of the Suburban Redevelopment Fund.
This is an Elysian housing development, Mac.
So Elysian is an investor in the redevelopment fund.
Looks that way.
Are we done here, Mac? I've got work to do.
Sure, buddy. Thanks for your help. Elysian are investors in the Suburban Redevelopment. So what? If you think I'm putting my pension on the line and harassing Leland Monroe without evidence, you're out of your mind. Who says we should visit him at Fire Station 32?
Who exactly is this guy, Lynch?
Lynch is a legend. You should feel privileged. He doesn't let many people into the inner sanctum. Keep your mouth shut, and you'll learn something about fires.
Boxing's on the card at St. Helena's Gym in the Bronx tonight. Golden Gloves Boxing.
We came as soon as we could.
Keep talking. Someday you'll say
Lynch.
Something intelligent.
Biggs, you two investigating the house fire on Kenmore Avenue as well?
Yep. Why?
I had a look around the place while I was out there.
Do you believe the fire?
I deal in facts, Phelps. Evidence of an explosion. No obvious sign of accelerants. Wiring looks intact. Come and take a look at this.
This the heater from the Sawyer fire, Al?
Yes, it is.
Huh. Looks like it was recently serviced.
I have a theory, and it's a theory only. I don't have enough evidence to prove...
Al, if you say it's so, we're listening.
Okay, Phelps. You're a bright penny. You have a gas supply. You have a Bunsen burner as a pilot light. You have a regulator valve, and the balloon represents the gas expanding in the room. Now, the gas has to make contact with the mosquito coil to form an explosion. Let's see if you can work out the chain of events.
The gas bubble needs to be next to the coil if it's going to ignite.
Good, your regulator's in position. You need to get the arrangement right before we can reproduce the results. Thank you. Okay, I'll light your pilot and turn the gas.
You pull the lever on the left to turn on.
So that's how it's being done.
Maybe. There could be a fault with these valves. I've adjusted this one for our experiment, but you need to take it to InstaHeat and see what they say. Their headquarters is on North Harvard Boulevard, number 262.
Thanks, Albert.
You're welcome, Biggs. See you at the next show.
Watch the Hammond Galahad fight. The mess that was. Anyway, that's the cop of court, the guy. I swear, this town is going straight to hell.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Fine. Where are we headed?
It's a lot of sin.
Show?
The next fire. We should go to the factory and see how many of these things are going bang in the night.
You know this Chapman character?
The guy's a freak. Loves fires. He's the kind of guy that we'd like for a lot of things, but we don't really have any credible evidence to pursue him with.
LAPD detectives, ma'am. We need to speak to someone in charge.
I see. Well, duty manager for today is Mr. Rasick. You should find him in his office.
A skeleton goes into a bar and orders a beer and a mop.
Is being sued for divorce by his wife after being caught in an illicit affair with a German drug addict.
I think his name was Phelps. He brought in that case for that poor lady killed near City Hall.
She wants a 5-star goddamn wedding.
Detective Phelps and Biggs, arson. We're investigating a couple of house fires. What can you tell us about this?
Pressure regulator from a Model 70. Let me take a look. We have a problem. This has been tampered with.
What?
You see this diaphragm? It forms a seal across the saddle here. Gas flows across from here to here. The diaphragm regulates flow. It's been reversed. It's a subtle change, but it means the gas never closes off properly.
So you're telling me that this is not a manufacturing fault or service repair?
I don't think there's anything inherently wrong with the design.
You're telling me that you've never had any problems with this heater?
Look, we've changed the design since the Model 70.
These things are still being installed?
It's the demand. None of us could keep up with the amount of housing going up. At the budget end, we're still using some of the old stock. We are installing 100 heaters a week. They're not all faulty.
They're not all safe either.
Are these diaphragms prone to failure?
They tend to go after a while. The rubber lasts quite a few years and then it perishes.
So the guy's names that I've been seeing doing the repairs on the heaters, they're fully licensed and accredited.
Sure, of course they are.
I think you're lying, Rasick. I think some of your men aren't fully licensed. You're desperate to cover your sales.
And how are you going to prove that, Detective? Name me one of my guys who would have overlooked a fault like this.
What about Matthew Ryan?
You know about Ryan, huh? All right, he's been in some trouble, I know that. He's done his time.
You in the habit of hiring criminals, Rasick?
I need guys, Detective. This boom is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
I want you to get me a copy of the list of your installers.
Okay, I'll get it for you. There, around a dozen of them. Housing business is going crazy at the moment.
This is a long shot. We are not going to roust that whole list.
I want to run it by R&I, cross-reference for arsonists. See if any of these guys have any previous. Sir, I need to use your phone.
Go right ahead.
As the cannibals finished off eating the clown, one said, "Did that taste funny to you?"
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need to know if any of the following names have a previous criminal history.
Okay, Detective, run the names.
Acevedo Ernesto, Clemens Walter, Elgrim John, Gable Leroy, Kellegrew Peter, Cutner Robert, Limehouse Albert, Manning Franklin, Neves Raymond, O'Brien Thomas, Ryan Matthew, Spurgeon William, Varley Reginald, Zurich Stephen.
Clemens Walter, previous conviction for arson and malicious damage. Burned down a house in Westwood in 1942. 4-year jail term.
Thanks.
Ryan Matthew, charged for contempt of court, attempted murder, plea bargained down to assault charge.
Anyone else?
There is a Reginald Varley wanted for murder by Detroit Police Department.
Thanks. You've been a big help, young lady. Your employment roster is quite the rogues gallery, Mr. Rasik. Desperate times indeed. Do you have an address for Clemens?
He's working on an apartment building on Catalina and 3rd.
What about Ryan?
Currently working at a housing development on Normandy and 1st Street.
Varley, where is he?
Beverly and Mariposa, currently working on a new housing development. Hey, Varley's a good guy. You can't harass all my people.
These guys have lockers.
Yes, they do, but my men have a right to some privacy. Don't you need a warrant or something?
Show him and keep quiet.
Here. Happy now?
Stick around, Mr. Rasik. Clemens is a fellow traveler. Some light reading on the merciless capitalist machine. Ryan wants the world to be a better place, don't we all? Company went through thousands of these in the war. Still got eaten alive. Varley has a problem with bugs.
You know that a mosquito coil takes an hour to burn down, Rasik?
No, I didn't know that.
It's the favorite choice of ignition by arsonists. Gives them time to get away.
You're crazy. He probably lives near the canals in Venice. Mind if I leave you to it? I got work waiting.
3 birds. Clemens, Ryan.